Okay, I just want to talk a little bit about the audio mixer, which we haven't talked about. It's pretty straightforward, but it's where you bring everything together in regards to the oscillators before they are processed by the filter. So, I just want to say this is the most vintage sounding modern synthesizer I think that's out there. I mean, it just has that natural vintage sound, which is fantastic. It's what we've been waiting for as far as, you know, certainly, for example, KORG's MS-20 was a very authentic remake of the MS-20. But the MS-20 had a very unique and interesting sound, whereas the ARP ODYSSEY is the foundation for the whole vintage sound of the 70s, along with the Mini Moog. And, well, I mean, certainly there were many other synthesizers, but the ARP ODYSSEY was one of the most popular and easiest to be found. And so as such, it has kind of a definitive factor. So it's really nice to hear something that has all of this vintage sound, which I haven't even talked about. But it really is a vintage sounding synthesizer. So let's use the mixer. Okay, we've got right now VCO2 playing a sawtooth. Let's bring in another sawtooth, the one from the VCO1. Sounds fantastic. It's the kind of thing I expect to hear from a vintage synth demo. So, I mean, it just makes me really happy. And we haven't talked about, like, for example, tuning. Because you have the whole range of the oscillator present just in one slider, there's no multiple switches or whatever, you can just, you know, certainly tune either oscillator to whatever pitch you want. So there's my enthusiasm. I mean, this is just so authentically. And we can mess it up too. Here, let's make it even more vintage. We got the noise generator in the sample and hold mixer. So I'm going to add it to the frequency of oscillator 2. Gives it a really gritty, nasty. This has been used in a club where smoking was still permitted sort of sound. And we can do that to the filter too. And if we wanted to add some noise to the sound in general, we could do that. This is where we can use either white noise or pink noise, which sound very, very similar. Oh no, you can definitely hear there's more low end. Well, there isn't more. It sounds like there's more low end to us. Okay, we've had enough sawtooth. We can also have square wave. Yeah, vintage. That's fantastic. We also have, I mean, certainly we have it mixed here. We can definitely mix. So you have a lot of opportunity there for different timbres. I feel like I'm in like a 1970s television show or like horror movie here. This is fantastic. There's so much technology. There's so much. The structure of the synthesizer is such that to get to the fun part, you have to go through a lot of the understanding of how the inner workings interwork. And now we're here. We're at a point now where we can start bringing this stuff together. And I've been waiting for this, and it's so great just to hear these sounds. Obviously, I'm getting a little crazy about it. Something we have not talked about yet is the ring modulator. Yeah, there's also a ring modulator in here. Let's have a listen to that. Of course, the ring modulator creates the sum and differences of the two oscillator waveforms added together. So we get all kinds of really wacky, great sounds. Let's face it, the ring modulator was like the source of a lot of synthesizer interest in the past. I mean, it led to the Buchla synthesizer being made. Was started off just as, hey, can you make a ring modulator? The ring modulator is a huge part of synthesizer history, and it's capable of some really crazy, wacky noises. Let's listen to some of them. What happens when we sync these oscillators and also have them acting as a ring modulator? I don't know the answer to this. I can't wait to see. Oh, well, that's something. Sounds just like so far there's been a lot of me going, well, these modulation choices can really add up to a wide variety of sounds or whatever, and here we are in the midst of experiencing how multiple functionalities modulating each other can lead to some really creative and interesting outcomes. We're not even using the filter. So yeah, a lot goes on in the mixer where we're bringing all of these different sound sources with their modulation sources and working our magic with them. Obviously, we're not just talking about a really simple synthesizer.